What's good, what's good? It's your boy Rico De La Cruz. I'm here with former boy band member Rayan, known as Ray Ray. What's good, bro? You know how it is, man. How it is, bro?
What's up? I think what's gonna make this interview so great is that we've been hanging out for 3 years.
Hell yeah. We've been hanging out like for so long now. Like, it's like brothers now.
Let me tell you how really he is. Yeah, I'll start it with a direct message to do the interview. And he said, fuck that. I'm gonna come to LA.
Yep.
We're gonna hang out. You're gonna take me to the and then we go to the interview.
Facts.
And now we're here.
Now we're here. Like, it's just good vibes. Like I said, I'm not like some regular podcasters, it's good vibes, you know what I mean? So for people that don't know who you are, if they don't know who you are, that's crazy. But let them know who you are, you know.
Yeah.
Let's bring from the jump of beginning
to now.
Yeah.
Very beautiful people, like you said, I'm Rayan, formerly known as Ray Ray from the group Mindless Behavior. I started dancing in the streets of LA, and from that I got noticed and auditioned for the group, developed with the group, and though people feel like it was an overnight success, it actually took a lot of fucking hard work. We blew up, we broke up. I was on a hiatus for about maybe 3-4 years, and then I finally start to get back on social media and work on my solo project and introduce who Rayan is, because I feel like everyone got attached to this, I don't want to call it a facade, but Ray Ray, you know, the younger me, or this ideal brand of me, which is okay, as they should have, but now I feel like it's time for them to know Rayan.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? My personal creative
ideas. Who you are.
Yeah,
you
know, not attached to 3 other guys.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And so like, how did the group start it? Like, how did it all start it? Like, who came up with Mind's Behavior? For those who don't know, you know?
Keisha Gabriel, she put us together. She also developed us. I'm not really going to mention anyone else, but Keisha and I, we still have a decent relationship.
Yeah.
But she's been doing this her whole life.
Yeah.
She grew up dancing, and she also put together B2K.
For us. All right.
So, you know, she has this background. She knew what she was doing.
She knew what she was doing.
So, you know, one day she was like, you know what, I'm going to do this shit again.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And she did it, and it turned out great.
Okay.
I got into the group from auditioning, probably discovered on YouTube. Roc was a street dancer like I was. Mm-hmm. He wasn't really the best dancer.
Yeah, I heard he wasn't the best.
Yeah, he wasn't the
best. It was like,
but he had that star.
He had the star.
You know what I mean? It's like you see that kid from the hood, you're like, he'd be something.
Yeah, he'd be something.
You know what I mean? Which is a good choice. And then old boy, who was just in the dance world.
Yo, that's why I love him. For me, this is me, bro. This is me. Anyways, so like, how was the group? Like, where was y'all based at? Like, where, like, was y'all living together?
Yes, we're living in this small house, decent house in Compton.
Mm-hmm.
We're living with,
Compton. Hold on,
Compton.
Compton.
There you like. Of Compton, like
Montefiore, living in Compton.
That's what we developed that for a year before we start touring. When we get off a tour, that's where we're living.
Okay.
We all shared a room together, literally, like had bunk beds. Bro. two here, like
major pain, Rob.
And once we like started making money, the garage we were rehearsing, but we were rehearsing the garage for like, you know, those mirrors that like. That you can fold out, like one long mirror.
Yeah. Everyone had their own mirror?
We used to rehearse in a mirror like that. And then once we started kind of getting decent money, Keisha had the whole garage turned into a dance studio.
Mm-hmm.
So it was crazy, like, it got to a point to where once we were known and we were going back to living there, we were rehearsing in this garage and then the block, like the kids from the block.
Yeah, because like, how was that? How was it so you're saying like, because Mom's Behavior was big. Like, you know what I mean? Like, we're not going to sit here and lie. Mom's Behavior was, I'll be 2K.
Yeah.
And Mom's Behavior was big. So how was it being so big and still living in Compton. How do people treat you guys? Like,
well, we stayed in Compton for like the next few years, I would say, to at least. So I started when I was 13. Mm-hmm. Then I stayed here to at least I was like 15, maybe 16.
Yeah.
It was both odd, but it was also, I think it was good for us because we come from the streets.
Yeah.
I come from South Central LA.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like leaving, you know what I mean, my family that are like living in an apartment building and
mm-hmm.
we're surviving, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
To like 5-star hotels and restaurants,
mm-hmm.
tour bus and whatever I want is handed to me. You know, yes, man, the whole event.
Yeah.
So I actually feel like it was good that we were going back to Compton. I was even going back to the hood sleeping on couches and shit because it humbled me.
Yes.
It showed me like what not to forget and what to respect.
Yeah.
And appreciate where I came from. But at the same time, that shit was uncomfortable. You know what I mean? Because like I said, I'm staying in 5-star hotels and I'm on BET and I'm on all this shit.
And you're going back,
but I'm going back. I'm going back here. So it was like a bittersweet thing.
Did you ever like question any financial problems with the group? Like did your parents said anything? Like did anybody like
towards the end
question? Because like my table was big.
Mm-hmm.
And y'all all over, like come on, from LA to mm-hmm. be known in New York, all over the world, UK, Africa, wherever, y'all was known. So like, nothing is not making no sense to me.
No, you know what I'm saying? So what it was, towards the very end, yes, because we started to get older. You have to understand, it's like, again, I hate to like, be repetitive, but we're from the streets. So, all money was good money. You know what I mean? Like, as long as we were doing better than before, it was kind of like that type of thing. And it wasn't until later on in the career did we actually, like, stop being naive and was like, okay,
mm-hmm.
where's the money? You know, and shit yeah. like that. And, you know, there was, you got bad people, you got good people in the industry.
Yeah.
And we dealt with both.
Yeah.
But we got money. You know what I mean? Like, so it was just like one of those things where it was just like bad team, definitely mm-hmm. taking advantage.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Like New Edition. Something yeah. like the New Edition.
Literally, mm-hmm. Literally that. So, yeah, it was that type of situation. Honestly.
Yeah, and then, you know, what made it more sad is like, you know, it made a lot of us sad, you know what I mean? Because y'all understand, y'all was like a big thing, and then, you know, the group came apart. And it's like,
mm-hmm.
like it came to an end.
Yeah.
It went from like.
I think it needed to, though.
You really think so?
I think it needed to.
Wow.
There was so much things behind the scenes that was going on.
Like.
That I think everyone kind of needed a break. The world wasn't ready for it.
Yeah.
But if y'all were in our shoes, you'll understand. Like, I left, or just like on my.
Yeah.
So I left literally the day I survived a terrible accident. Because that was like a wake up call to me.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, damn, if I would have died in this moment,
mm-hmm.
I would have been a pissed angel. Like, because I didn't get to express my former art.
Yeah.
I was someone's puppet, someone's idea of a musician.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And so that was just like, so that was like part of me leaving. Plus, like I said, I wasn't naive anymore. I was seeing little shit. I was seeing, you know what I mean, just the facades and the fraudulent
yeah.
know, things that were going on. So that was just like really like a call for me. Like, okay, I got to step away from this. Plus, it was falling apart for a while. People don't know that, but it was really falling apart for a while. Like, it looked so cute on the outside, mm-hmm. but on the inside, where there was like members not getting along.
Yeah.
You know, there was team trying to keep us away from certain people, but it was just so much going on.
Yeah, because, like, as I've seen, like, I know you don't not want to talk for somebody else, mm-hmm. but I see how, like, Pride, you know, like,
yeah.
I see how, like,
Pride had to leave.
I see the comments, you know, the fans, they're saying, like, what's wrong with Pride, you know,
yeah.
why he looked depressed. He was never talking in any yeah. interviews.
He had to leave.
Why you say
that? He had to do that to get better. Probably, you understand, he came from, I think, Philly.
Yeah.
He came to L.A. No parents, nobody. to start staying out in LA with us, developing with us. He came from, I think, what, Philly. You know, he came to LA. No parents, nobody. To start staying out in LA with us, developing with us. He was, it's just a child retort from his family. That's already a lot in itself.
Yeah.
Now you're put in a position to be the lead. Now you have to carry a brand. Though we all carried it together, and the consumer eyes, it's elite. It's like the Marriott.
Yeah, yeah.
So now he just had just so much pressure, and he had to learn discipline. We're 13 years old. You know how hard it is to learn discipline? On another level.
Yeah.
It's not like the average kid that goes to school.
Yeah.
Y'all come home and do your homework. And
child
then you
was taken away. It was just like, yo, yeah, come work.
Nah. Yeah, it wasn't that simple. It was like, we literally had books. Like weekly books with new schedules that we had to abide by. Wake up, eat breakfast, stretch, workout, after workout, 3 hours at home school, after 3 hours at home school, go to the studio, after studio, do rehearsals, after rehearsal, do another workout, after that workout, then dinner. And then, right, it was like, we're like robots. So then we had to learn, after all that, it was like, okay, now you're going to roll. So here are your rules when you go on the road. You can't do this, you can't do that, you can't do this, you do this, you do that. But like, there would be times where we're literally doing so many interviews and shit that we weren't even getting sleep. And I said we're 14, we're 15 at the time.
Yeah, because I seen a video with Roc Royal. He was like, y'all was doing like training, like rehearsing, and he was tired. He was really tired, and I'm like, wow, like.
No, yeah, bro.
Y'all mad young, and I feel like, damn, like.
Bro, literally.
Yeah, like, I'm gonna wake up, like, yo, yeah. Like, damn, you kids, like.
No joke, we're literally, like, take a tour bus, right? let's say New York, right? We take a tour bus to New York. Let's say we get there, let's say 4 a.m.
Yeah.
We literally go in, sleep for an hour, take a shower, get dressed. By 6, 7, we're doing interviews up until, like, 12. Damn. Then we go back to the hotel, shower up again, you know what I mean? Because we need to go to the venue. Do a meet and greet at fucking, remember, like, was it FYI? It was like shit like that.
Yeah.
6,000 people, you know what I mean? So now we got to take all these pictures, we got to sign all these autographs. Then after that, we go to the actual show venue, do a show. After the show, we got to do the actual tour meet and greet. Like, bro, it was, our days were long.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, yeah.
So, like, the discipline that we had to take on was a lot. But on Prod end, I feel like he had to take on a bit more than us, not because of a lead, but like I said, he was tore away from his family as a kid. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He actually missed, though we all missed our family and shit like that, he missed his a bit more than everybody else.
Yeah.
And I'm not really going to speak on his behalf, but there was just a lot of shit that he just had to deal with the team and with, you know what I mean, and shit like that.
Do you think that the fans treated Prod the same as they treated you, Roc, and Grunt? Let's be honest, like,
I'm gonna be completely honest. It's
like, do you feel like, when you was on that stage, honestly,
no, you know, absolutely. That's the thing. So, and this is no disrespect to no one, but even with Prod being the lead singer,
yeah,
he wasn't the biggest in the group.
You feel like he was like muted, right? Like,
not muted, but. You know, people just attracted to their favorites. Everybody had their own style.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It was the hair.
The two braids, the colors, you got the mohawk.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then you got to think, like, so Prod, he's like, the people looked at him like, he's the cool kid of the town.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you want the little chocolate dude, there you go. You know what I mean? Then you got me, I'm super fashion forward, you know what I mean? I'm like this, I have like an androgynous look, so a super pretty boy. I have a long hair.
Yeah.
So if you go for that, there you go.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You got Roc, he's the hood, he's the rapper.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? He got his hat, his ponytail. You know what I mean? Like, if you saw him walking down the street, you're like, oh, who that?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, everyone just had their own,
their own things.
You know what I mean? Then you have the other kid, he got the fro, he got the, you know what I mean? He got culture. You know what I mean? So everybody just had something to attract to, which was fire.
Yeah.
So, like I said, though he was the lead, he wasn't the biggest because everybody had their own thing.
Now, Roc Royal, like, you still talk to him? What, Santo, August, you go by now?
Santo, yeah.
Yeah, Santo, do y'all still, like, speak?
Actually, I just talked to him for the first time in years. A few days ago, he caught me from jail, and we had a really long talk. And I ended up talking to him like 2-3 times since then. So we've been keeping in touch, just making sure he's straight, making sure his family's straight. He lost his mom recently.
Which is big.
You know, just him being locked up, like he didn't have the privilege to see her. You know what I mean? It's a lot. So we reconnected recently, which is good because out of everybody in the group, me and Rock were close because we come from the same exact area.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, his family is my family.
Yeah, because I seen in y'all, like in the videos, like the MB Cam day, that would just be like,
it was us.
Us.
Yeah. Like, it was one point when we were on tour, Rock and I had our own tour bus.
Were?
Like, it's kind of fucked up, but like, Pride, Prince, they had a tour bus with like, the dancers, the camera crew, and our tour bus was literally like, Carter, our bodyguard, may he rest in peace, our driver, Rock and I, and Aaron. You know what I mean? Like,
rock stars. Rock stars.
We're that close.
Like,
that was my brother. You know what I mean? Like, I've been in his life since when I was 13, he was, what, 11. You know what I'm saying? So, like,
that's like a little brother, little
bro.
Big brother.
He kind of big.
So, all the advice came from me.
Yeah.
All the bullshit, the tour life.
Yeah, came from you.
Came from me. You know what I mean? Like, I was really, like, guiding him in that way.
Do you know when he's coming home?
He got some time. I know exactly. I don't know the exact date, but he got some more years. Damn. Yeah.
That's so crazy.
But I feel like now that we reconnected and we had that talk, and he regretted his decisions. Mm-hmm. He's learning from them. I feel like you said, as a big brother, you know, now it's my responsibility to make sure he's straight on it. You know what I mean?
So, I see when the group broke up and Carl left, right? Mm-hmm. Now y'all got a new member that was EJ. Right?
True. It was EJ.
It was EJ first. And then the other gunner. Who was it? EJ, the light skinned one, right?
Sorry, yes.
And then, Mike is the one that came out here. Mike came after EJ.
Yes.
Okay, so how did you feel about the group when they replaced it Prod with EJ and then you got Mike in? Was it like an awkward for you? Or did it get like, how did it, Santo left, right? Santo left.
He got kicked out.
Okay, he got kicked out.
I left eventually.
Okay, so Prod left.
I was in there when Mike and EJ.
Yeah, I seen that. Mm-hmm. So Prod left, Santo get kicked out. Well, Rock get kicked out, right? Mm-hmm. Now, it's you, Princeton, EJ, and Mike. How was it? Like, did you feel sad that, like, did you ever just look at the group and be like, yo, wow.
You gotta understand, at this point, I was so in my own zone. I was so in my own world. I was so focused on Rayan at this point.
Yes.
And Ray twice. I had, you know, the clothing brand going. I was working on music. I was living in my own apartment up in North Hollywood. Like, I was literally living my own life. And at this point, everything is so destroyed in a way that I'm not even thinking. I'm like, okay, it's been 2 years since we dropped the album, or like about a year since we dropped the album. Like, what are we doing? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So at this point, I'm just like, all right, I'm going to just focus on me. Mm-hmm. I'm not even worried about the group. And then I get a call like, hey, we want you to do the replacements, whatever. So it gets funny because before Mike even came, it was this other kid. He's actually from New York.
What's his name?
Is it Joshua? He be singing. Light skinned kid. Talented, amazing singer. We went to, this is really funny, but we went to Atlanta. Mm-hmm. And that's when we met him for the first time. And this is my first time really meeting EJ too. Mm-hmm. So we go to Atlanta. And yeah, I think EJ was there, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
We go to Atlanta and we're staying at R. Kelly's house. Right? And he wanted to do a few tracks for us. And I was so not feeling it. At this point, I'm so out of touch with the group.
Yeah, it's like, you know what I mean? Like, it's like you just lost hope. Like,
yeah, no, yeah, it was, yeah.
You
no,
look, yo, yeah. You started your own brand. Like, you clearly lost hope of the brand.
So I just remember, bro, that trip was crazy. I'll never forget that trip. But, so we go there, and bro, we're in the studio, and our team is like, y'all gotta hear these songs, man. Blah, 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 blah. And I'm sitting in the studio, I'm not feeling nothing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Man, you gotta get in the studio to do this. And I'm like, no, I won't. So the whole time, we were there for about a week or two, the whole time I didn't record a lick of music, not a verse, right? So, but we talk, me and you will talk more about that trip. Yeah. It was a weird one. But, yeah. And then we went to Miami to record with these other producers. And I'll never forget that too, because we went out there and the situation they had us in was just so trash, bro. I think, like, I'm not even gonna joke, bro. Like, I had a girl come pick me up and I ended up staying with her, like, you know what I mean, yeah. Type thing. And then I finally ended up going to the studio. So now at this point, this is when Mike
and Jim,
because they decided not to go with it. I think, I want to say the name Josh Hill, but I don't want to be wrong. So this is me meeting Mike. And already, they're talented.
Yes.
Do not get me wrong. But they will never be Mindless Behavior.
Yeah.
I don't care what differences me and the other members got between Jacob and I, or Prince and I, because we haven't talked in years. We don't talk. Pride and I, we stay connected. That's it. Rock and I just, I don't care who got whatever going on, that's Mindless Behavior.
Yeah, Mindless Behavior. That's what everyone says.
Period.
Yeah, you know, picture. It's like,
yeah.
We watch how I grew up. Like, we all grew up together.
Exactly.
So it's like, yo, no disrespect to E, J, and I, but that's like, that just can't, it just can't happen.
Yeah, no, yeah.
You know what I mean?
So, we go there, and they wanted me to record some stuff, and I would. And then they begged me to record this one verse. And so I did. I recorded like half of it, I think. I don't even think I recorded it for them. And I'm listening to the music, and I'm just like, bro, this isn't me. This isn't me, bro. Like, we're talking about like getting a hickey on our necks, and I'm just like, seriously, like I'm 17 now. You know what I mean? I'm 17, 18 at this point. What the fuck are we singing about?
Yeah.
We found at this point, each one of us has probably found Mrs. Right at least fucking four times in our life.
Yeah, we're...
Had them, been with them, dumped them.
Yeah.
Without the world seeing.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, all this kiddie shit now. Like.
So I couldn't relate to it.
Yeah.
And then literally that's... I left Florida. Came back. My accident happened. That's when I just officially left.
What happened to the accident?
I was driving.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was both of our fault. It was my fault and it was also the driver.